Good morning, everyone. As Alexei said, my name is Jim Calverley. I'm the product manager for the Fujifilm FinePix 3D digital products line. And before I start, I'd like to ask everyone, who here does 3D digital photography or knows someone very well that does 3D digital photography? So only a few people. So let me give you a little frame of reference. Before we came to the market in the U.S. in September with a digital stereo digital camera, this was what you needed to do in order to get digital photography in stereo or in 3D. You needed to purchase two cameras. You needed to purchase an aluminum rail that these cameras mount on, and then you would send it to some person who was very, very gifted in hacking into camera software, and they would be able to synchronize the two shutter buttons into one shutter button on this rig that you see in front of you here, and then you would be able to record two stereo images on two different pieces of media, of course. Then you'd have to bring those into your computer at home, combine them with some type of software, and then have some type of way to display them for you and for your friends and family. So why the stereoscopic community is so excited about our product coming out this year is because we gave them a product that you can do this with and that takes 3D digital images. So the FinePix REAL 3D W1 digital camera is a true stereo digital device with two 3x optical Fujinon lenses and two 10-megapixel CCDs that writes to a single SD card and really introduces the simplicity and the convenience and the portability into the stereoscopic community that many, many in that community have been really anxious to get. But as you know, with any new product development, you have to come out with a total solution. And at Fujifilm, we've come out with the beginning of a total solution for our consumers that are interested in 3D photography. And the premise of that is shoot, view, and print. And of course, the basis of that is the camera. The W1, as I mentioned, dual 10-megapixel, dual 3x optical zoom lenses. But it also will do 2D images. It has some very unique 2D modes, as you can imagine, because we have two lenses and two CCD imagers. We can take both a zoom and a wide-angle shot simultaneously. We can also take a high ISO and a standard ISO shot simultaneously, do some other interesting convenience things like that. Instant 3D playback is another important feature of the camera, and if you'll notice, when you come and see me in the tech fair later on, which I hope you'll do, that there is a 3D screen built into the back of the camera as well. So you can see and get instant gratification for what you're shooting in 3D. You can see it instantly. And that, again, is another first and a unique feature for our camera. We also have a photo frame, which is the view portion of our solution. The photo frame is an 8-inch photo frame. That will show you 3D with the naked eye. It is based on a parallax viewing system. A parallax barrier viewing system. It has nice, simple touch bar controls that light up when you're using them, and they shut down when you're not, so that it doesn't take away from the viewing pleasure of what's on the screen. It comes with a remote control. It'll connect USB via the camera, USB via your computer. It will also transfer via infrared from the camera directly to the viewer onto the 512 megabytes of space that's available on internal memory on the viewer as well. So the viewer allows us to instantly view those images that we capture with the camera. And then, of course, the last part of our initial total solution for the customer is the print solution. And we have a laboratory set up in Japan that can print lenticular prints at a 5x7 size. The way you would do that is to upload your stereo image that you capture with the camera to our seehere.com photo printing site. And SeeHere would forward those images to our Japanese lab. They would create the lenticular images and send them right back to you. And that all happens within the scope of about 2 weeks or less. So our customers can now instantly view on the back of the camera. They can view and share with their family and friends on the viewer. And they can also print and save those images in a printed form. So that gives us a total solution for the customer. But we have the total solution. That's the first step. The second step is we need to rally the industry and make a stronger 3D solution to the end user, to the retail customer, so that they don't just say, oh, well, you know, if I buy this, the only way I can look at it is on the Fujifilm frame or pay for the Fujifilm prints. How else can I use this? So we need some flexibility and some diversity in the industry to gain larger consumer acceptance, and really that's what it's all about, isn't it? So we've partnered with NVIDIA, who makes a shutter glasses 3D system called 3D Vision that works quite well with the images that we capture on our W1 digital camera. NVIDIA uses our cameras when they go out and do their grassroots marketing initiatives, and we also use their 3D Vision system and certain marketing display events that we go to as well to demonstrate yet another option of displaying and enjoying the content that you can create on the W1 digital camera. As well, some other kind of little less well-known types of applications, such as the wonderful Stereo Photomaker software. This is a freeware software program that most of the stereoscopic community is aware of and uses regularly. It is totally free to use. It's an executable file, as a matter of fact. You don't even have to install it, per se. And it allows you to manipulate stereo images. And as of their last software update, it is now compatible with the .mpo file that is created in the W1 digital camera. So this is yet some other ways outside of Fujifilm that that you can enjoy the content that you create with the camera. Other manufacturers we've been speaking to, Sharp Electronics, who has a rather nice rear projection display, a rear projector that does 3D display, as well as JVC has a very nice 46-inch commercial flat screen that they sell primarily to movie makers, Hollywood, places like that. So there's more and more content coming. We can't wait to get to CES this year to see who else is going to join in this revolution of 3D. So one last thing that I want to share with you today, because many, many people are asking us, well, where can you buy it? How come you only have it here and not here? And how come this thing isn't on Amazon.com and isn't on the post at Best Buy and things like that? Well, as you can imagine, when you're the only product on the market and you're a product that is not instantly compatible with the consumer's home electronics array, so to speak. In other words, this is a product that you can't just go home and plug it into your TV and look at it and get 3D instantly, right? There's a process. You can't just plug it into your computer, download it, and watch it on your computer. There's a process. So with that process comes a little bit slower consumer acceptance. So as we move cautiously. We take one hurdle and then we move on to the next one. For example, our first focus is on the stereoscopic community. These are people that have been waiting for the camera, that understand exactly what the camera does, what its capabilities are, what its limitations are, and what they need to do with it once they take the picture or capture the movie, by the way, which I forgot to mention at the beginning. This also shoots movies at 640 by 480 VGA resolution. So we need to get in line with the stereoscopic enthusiasts, which we've been doing over the past couple of months or so since the camera's been available in the U.S. And they're a customer that gets it already. So when we sell it to them, they know what it's going to do for them. The chances are that there's going to be some type of a poor review from them or some type of incompatibility with their system is very small because they already know what it takes to use this product in their hobby. Okay. So it's a safe bet for us. So we've been having some success with this community. They're talking about it on the internet. They're very positive about it. Again, the biggest thing that they love about it is that pocketability that they never had before.